Morning, guys and gals. Hang on, any gals watching this? I'd be interested to know. Say hi in the comments if you are, because this often tends to be a little top-heavy in the bloke department, so always good to hear when the fairer sex are interested in this stuff. Can we say that these days? I don't know. Well, getting on with it. If you caught me recent post, you will be thinking, ah, here comes that face video, finally, Well, like I seem often to do, I have changed my mind. Why have I changed my mind? A number of reasons, but one of them is I was working with Vase 2.2 and WAN 2.2, if you recall, and something struck me. Firstly, because WAN Animate is out, everyone is off chasing that, but also something I saw posted by a guy. He had been doing a lot of work with Vase, very successfully, and you might have seen his result. It was a gorilla taking the place of Neo being trained to fight in the Matrix. Well, I followed his work with keen interest because I have had my tussles with Vase and know the wins and the tears that can follow. He did a very good job on it, but it took its toll. Damn if this game isn't like that. He finished it finally because VFX guys are like that and will hang on like a polecat to a finger, and yes, I do know what that feels like because I had one. But his final words after getting through the task he set himself were this. Not his final words, you understand, but final comment on the experience.
If I had to do it all over again, I think I'd use QuinEdit to generate a synthetic data set of the gorilla in different poses and so on. I'd train a Laura for Flux, since that's way simpler and faster. And I'd mess around with first to last frame techniques instead of going full Vase with control net and references.
Now, if you had lived and loved like me, and I think his name is pronounced Neko de Ficodor, but if you had lived and loved on the road to Vase like we had, you would know there is pain on that road. Pleasure, certainly, but pain too. I agree with him, and that got me thinking. That and the fact everyone is chasing Wanamator right now. And what did he get me thinking? That it is time to get on with making something with all this stuff. But he voiced something that I had not considered. That FFOF, i.e. first frame, last frame, might just be a better approach. I don't agree with his comments about QuinEdit, mostly because I haven't used it or seen results from it to beat Nano Banana yet, but rather than dive too deeply into it nor here, suffice to say, I am now drawing a line in the sand, and from this moment on I will be headed toward making my next AI short film. I will of course share valuable info as I make progress in that with you guys, and the first of those is the subject of today's video. Will I do a video on Vase? Yes, I almost certainly will, but if you read the research page on my website, you will already know that this period of research has led me to some conclusions.
Hang on while I dig out what I said about that. It turns out I haven't posted it yet, but I will be, and it is this.
Want work with one models to get best quality at 16 FPS at 720p if possible. 2. Convert 16 FPS to 21 FPS, also outscaling to 1080p in the process. 3. Take that 1080p 21 FPS and run it through a USD U Detailer 1. Finally, take the clip into DaVinci Resolve for colorization and final cut.
Now, what I didn't mention is how I get stage one mentioned above, but I can tell you now that I think good image editing software, along with Vase and WAN 2.2, is how I will achieve it, but not with character swapping Vase into video, but by using Vase in the FFLF workflow. So, Vase images are where it is at. I have, of course, already shared an excellent Vase image-to-image workflow for swapping in characters to new camera angles. So, that is what I am going with. I really should have saved all this for the next video, but I have laid it out here. The other two things he said in that quote that I also wouldn't be doing is using Flux or creating a Laura for Flux. Why not? Well, Nano Banana set a precedent, and I don't think it will be very long before open source has much better image editing options, and we no longer need to train Lauras for base images. I also have a free access to Nano Banana. At least limited free access, but enough it seems, to use it for character creation at different angles, and I plan to. I'll keep you posted on how that goes, but I'll tell you one thing, and I call it the campfire test. I might have mentioned it before, but Nano Banana cannot do a proper 180-degree camera rotation from the opposite end of your current shot. In fact, none of them can. Someone, yes, an egghead I spoke to, said it's actually very difficult to achieve. I left it at that. But preliminary tests just to me that image editing software is now very close to being good enough to not need Laura training characters or using Vase to character swap people back in. I also had other problems with Vase when doing that with three characters into the same video, but I won't go into it here. So, finally, we're at the point of this video. It only took 5 minutes of my gibbering, but we got there. Hopefully it was useful info. Remember my formula? The guideline that overarches all things. It is time plus energy versus quality. My 80-day experience making the 10-minute short narrated noir footprints in Eternity taught me well. We must make sacrifices in quality at this stage in the game to save time and energy. thankfully not too much. But those are the things I will be talking about moving forward. And in that vein, let us finally begin with today's video subject. Slow motion smoothness, and yes baby, I want it buttery smooth. Nothing else will do. Lubed up more buttery than a rent boy at a diddy party.
Wasn't me.
Slow motion smoothness. Firstly, what am I talking about and what constitutes NERT slow motion smoothness? Let's have a look. Here is AI Inez. I'll talk about it more in a future video. I'm showing this to you here so you can see what I'm trying to achieve. As you know, the average length of a ComfyUI One video clip is 81 frames. That is the limit. It also comes out of WAN at 16 frames per second. That is also set in stone. Yes, Phantom and others which are based on WAN 2.1 have been trained to a ratio of 25 FPS or 25 FPS at 121 frames, but we won't get into that here. Basically, we are locked at this current time to 81 frames at 16 frames per second, which is roughly 5 seconds of video. There are tricks to extend it, and I won't get into that here either. But looking at my AMS storyboard management system, and you can see my opening shots involve a lake scene at dawn. What you probably also gathered from looking at it is that I plan to have a slow zoom in of the camera until I get to the lake, or close to it. So assume that first shot is just lots of mist. What we have going on here is about 20 seconds of camera motion to the point the camera changes shot to the crow. Okay, if any of you have tried to do something like that, you will know extending shots in a tidy way is tricky. Now, there are camera shots and there are camera shots, and what we are talking about here is a particular type, the slow zoom in camera shot. Maybe it has a technical name, but the point is the same. It needs to be buttery smooth. The other place we need to add smoothing is in motion shots and especially sideways movement, and I have shared some of my trials and tribulations regarding a dolphin and a mermaid and a dead bloke in one of my shorts. On my shorts, I'm not talking about using the lube again, but rather YouTube shorts. But this should be easy in this context, should it not? Like heck it is. But there is a way, and I will show you. Though strictly speaking, it isn't just ComfyUI I have to use here to achieve it. Ignoring the mist, because I can add that in later as an afterthought in production. How do I get 20 seconds of motion going from shot one to the fourth shot and finally switch to the crow? Well, I have tried extending it, and I even looked at tricking Infinite Talk into doing it without a character or voiceover, but all of them failed. So, I cheated. Kind of. Because there really is no cheating in this game, only end results. And let's look at that end result quickly so you can at least know what I am talking about. Impressed? You bloody should be, that is not easy to do. I am presuming that it survived the upload to YouTube, and you may have spotted a couple of things that give away the underlying condition of it, and we'll talk about that in a moment. But I'll play it again and talk as it plays, so here it is. And this is just over 19 seconds, not only it is 24 frames per second, it is 1920 by 1080, so it's 1080p. And it is Final Cut quality, but for the fact I might add mist later, and it hasn't been further colorized. So, how did I do it? Things to note. There are no seams to look for, so don't bother doing that. And I bet you were. This has been done in one shot. That is using first frame, last frame method, and indeed initially just 81 frames at 16 frames per second, because you cannot do WAN any other way. What I have then done, we'll talk you through shortly, but first let me show you the thing to watch in order to understand how tough smoothing these shots out is. One advantage is that it zooms directly forward. One disadvantage is the tree. Trees are problematic, and I spent a long time fighting a tree on footprints in eternity. In fact, let me just quickly show you that shot if I can find it. Because back in May 2025, I did not find a solution. See the tree, and my God, was that a pain in the ass to get even that quality. Took me a long time. I don't even recall how I achieved it in the end. Voodoo, probably. But trees will make your shots look bad if you do not manage them properly. It's all those fiddly branches and so on. It also means that extending shots is problematic. Because what if your WAN model doesn't feel like putting all the branches in the same place? So that was why I went for the single shot, and you have probably guessed, interpolated the crap out of it. Also risky for quality reasons, but let it get back to the point. And when we are discussing how I got to the end result, keep your eyes peeled for the two leaves that passed at about the quarter point mark, and on the right, they are in the water. That will give you a much better insight into the frame rate and the judder that is actually happening between each frame. Let's look at the final cut again first, and this time watch for those leaves going by. about the 6 second mark in this 20 second shot. I let it play on so you could feast your eyes on the wonder.
But did you see them? The leaves going by?
I shall play just that part again so you can check them out. Here they are. The thing to note is that you can very much see the judder. Let me just give you at the back one close-up of that happening just to be sure the small screen guys can really grasp what I am talking about. Okay, so now let's talk about the stages I went through to make this shot and to make it buttery smooth. Slow motion. Step one, I use my FFLF first frame, last frame workflow, and I disabled the control net. You probably can't see it, but I unplugged the control net from the vase encode completely, but left it in as it's interchangeable. You can see in the first and last frame input image slots that I have the second shot from my image storyboard and the fourth shot. It's enough for what I needed. I am putting this through Vase 2.2 and WAN 2.2 models. You'll just have to take my word for that. And the weird neon green node is just me saving out latents because I was experimenting with that at the time. The end result was, of course, 81 frames at 16 frames per second. And in this FFLF workflow that I talked about the other day, could have been 720p. That is 1280 by 720 in resolution, but I actually went for 1020 away by 576 because I know we'll get a bump in the USDU workflow and it doesn't need higher quality than that. So let's have a look at the result of this FFLF workflow. 81 frames at 1022 by 570 resolution. It's not too bad. There is a light burst, but the whole thing holds together as it should. So that's fine. I then went from there to the interpolation workflow, where I upscale it very quickly with a standard ComfyUI upscaler and push it through Rife node using some trickery to get it to 1080p and 20 quen frames per second. You can get the workflow for that from the interpolation section of my website on the research page. And this is what the result of that looked like. 1080p and 20 quen frames per second, but still 5 seconds long. Just a lot more frames than 81. I think 121 at this point. Now you might be asking what the difference is at this stage, as that looks pretty good. But if you open it up in a big screen and look at it in something like VLC Media, you will see a lot of what Hall Lamarche going on with the tree leaves. I don't know if any of you took acid in the 60s. I didn't. I took it in the 90s, but it was pretty strong. And one of the things I remember about that was lizards. No, not lizards. I mean trees. They come alive and start breathing, man. Really, they do. Yeah. But getting back to their point, I don't want breathing trees in my shot. I probably don't need any talking lizards either. That was a weird trip. But anyway, at this stage, our 1080p 24 frame per second shot is suffering from Blancmange tree effect, and the leaves are zooming. That is another word I made up, but it sounds perfectly accurate what those leaves are doing. Those leaves are zooming, zooming, like Blancmange trees would. And before I start getting acid flashbacks or you call the cops and get me banned for suggesting we all take hallucinogenics, let him move swiftly on like a lubed lizard to the next shot and workflow, which is thus the USDU offscaler detailer low denoise workflow. And again, it's on my research page under WAD scaling, and you can download it for free from there. And as we head toward the 15 minute marker, I better get my skates on. This is the result of the USDU low denoise detailer that hopefully gets rid of most of the Blancmange tree zooming effect. It is still 1080p and it is still 25 frames per second and it is still only 5 seconds long, but we have arrived at the final stages. So what do we do next? Well, this is where we leave ComfyUI, but we stay with free products. Free, at least, with caveats. We're going to Shotcut, where we run a motion-driven interpolation to take it up to 120 frames per second. Shotcut is free and has no caveats, but we move from there to DaVinci Resolve, which is free, but does have commercial caveats, but still is the best tool for the job, and I use the free version, but might buy it because it is so damn good. And ignoring the weird mist dabbled effect, you can see top middle shows This is a 24 frame per second timeline in DaVinci Resolve, and you can see my clip loaded in there in the lower timeline. And I select that clip and haven't shown it here, but I right click and change the clip speed, and because it is 120 frames per second, it should handle reduction divided by 5 or 4, whatever the hell I did to get it slowed down to 20 second long, but that doesn't quite get rid of the judder, so we add the stuff you can see on the right, which is some retime processing and some motion estimation. And even in the free seats, they give us just enough quality that when I export that at 20 frames per second to an MPP out, we are back where we started this conversation with buttery smooth slow motion. It's as good as I need. I could say more, but I feel we're out of time. So until next time, my lizard licking lube loving lexbialidosus amigos, try not to get arrested and avoid the blue microdots unless you want to see talking lizards and dance naked in the streets. Ciao for now, bambinos.